Today we're going to be talking about some more news circulating around the Spyro Trilogy remaster that's supposed to be releasing on the PlayStation 4 later this year. It's not officially announced, but we've got more nuggets of information pointing on that. Also, we're going to talk about the commercial success of Monster Hunter World. That game has performed incredibly well, and we want to give you guys a heads up on the fantastic PlayStation Store sale that is ending tomorrow morning. This is the last full day for the PlayStation Store sale. Not a lot of gamers are talking about it, and there are some incredible deals available right now, so we'll give you a heads up on that. We made a formal video going over some of the best deals available during this sale, so you can check that out if you're interested, but we'll talk a little bit about that sale at the end of this video since this is the last day. First, let's talk about the Spyro Trilogy remaster coming off the very successful Crash Insane Trilogy that was released last year. That game performed incredibly well from a commercial and critical standpoint. Reviews were good, sales were good, and the amazing thing about that game's performance is that game did not have a huge marketing push, and the fact that that game did still sell really well just goes to show how far nostalgia can take you. But in the case of Crash the Insane Trilogy, they're great games as well, even to this day. And another franchise that Activision owns and gamers want to see make a comeback is, of course, Spyro. Kotaku had a report a while ago that a Spyro collection was coming, similar to the Insane Trilogy. It was going to be a collection of the first three Spyro games, Spyro the Dragon, Ripto's Rage, as well as Year of the Dragon, all in one collection, graphical improvements, all that good stuff. And while that is yet to be confirmed, we've got more information pointing towards that direction. If you actually look towards the coding of the Insane Trilogy, the Spyro demo code is actually in there. This was pointed out by Twitter user Matt B, and that just seems so odd to keep in a game's code. So if that doesn't point towards a trilogy remaster, I don't know what will, but we've also got more information on top of that. The voice actor of Spyro in the very first Spyro game, Carlos Alazaraki, sorry if I mispronounced that, also posted a tweet back on March 3rd saying, "Wonder what was happening here? Anyone know?" And he attaches a GIF of Spyro the Dragon with the hashtag Spyro and screenshot Saturday. That just seems very out of the blue at a time where we're anticipating the announcement of a Spyro trilogy, and now he just decides to post something like this. That seems oddly fishy. Maybe he heard the rumors, maybe he has nothing to do with it, although I would assume he would have something to do with it. So that's just something else to look at. Honestly, with the success of Crash Bandicoot the Insane Trilogy, not only did that open the pathway for a brand new Crash Bandicoot game, but I know Activision must be looking at the vault and the collections that they can produce, because at the end of the day, these games, to create them, cost a lot less than creating a brand new game from ground up. And it's not like we as gamers are even turned off by it one bit. We'd love to see a Spyro collection. Someone like me, Spyro was one of the very first games I played on the PlayStation 1, and to go back and play those games again with better visuals, that would be a dream come true. Especially on the PlayStation 4 now, you've got trophy support, all that good stuff. Let's hope it happens, and I assume it will happen. A collection will probably be released by the end of the year. Moving on from that, Monster Hunter World is one of the early contenders for 2018's Game of the Year. Don't want to push the cart before the horse since we are only in March, but the game is a tremendous title, easily the best in the Monster Hunter franchise, and now with it being on the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One, soon to be on the PC later this year as well, the potential audience for Monster Hunter has really been widened over the Nintendo platforms and the PlayStation Portable, and that shows with Monster Hunter World shipping 7.5 million copies, and that's only since its release. That is an incredible number, especially when you consider that Monster Hunter has always been a relatively niche franchise, but maybe it was only niche on the basis that it was relegated to platforms like the PlayStation Portable, the Nintendo Wii. Not to say that those platforms aren't great, but obviously having the game on the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox One is gonna widen that potential audience. And you might say the Wii sold millions upon millions of units, but let's be real here. A lot of the ardent hardcore gamers do own a PlayStation 4 and Xbox One, and it's good to tap into that market. And with Monster Hunter World selling 7.5 million units, not only does this mean that this is a highly successful game, the best in Capcom history, what this also means is Monster Hunter on the PlayStation and Xbox is probably going to be here to stay. Whether we see another Monster Hunter game before the end of the life of the PlayStation 4, that remains to be seen, but I'm sure at some point we'll be seeing another Monster Hunter game. For right now, Capcom is focused on keeping Monster Hunter World updated, and that's great to see. The game itself already has a huge amount of content, and it's great to see Capcom being rewarded for a high quality product. Finally, we're gonna round out this video just letting you guys know that the PlayStation Store Critics' Choice sale is ending tomorrow morning at 11 a.m. This sale is really good and it has some awesome deals. Not a lot of gamers are really talking about it. This is one of those sales that has kind of gotten under the radar when you talk about like the Black Friday digital deals and all those kinds of deals. Nobody's really talking about the Critics' Choice sale, but there are some fantastic deals, including Neo the Complete Edition for $25. $30, Horizon Zero Dawn Complete Edition for $32, The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt Complete Edition for $20, that's a fantastic deal, The Last of Us Remastered for $10, Dying Light The Following Enhanced Edition for $15, and so many other great deals, so make sure you give that a look. A lot of you guys did comment saying that these sales come at a horrible time, you're out of money, whatever the case may be. If that's the case for you, that's very unfortunate, but for those of you with some spare change, some awesome deals available right now. Some games that are super cheap. A game like Oxenfree is only $5, and that's a fantastic game. So take a look at our video covering the top 10 deals of this sale if you have not yet. And that is going to conclude this video. Let us know your thoughts. What do you think about the potential of a Spyro trilogy? I know that's something many of us are very excited for. What do you think about Monster Hunter World performing as well as it has from a commercial standpoint? Shipping 7.5 million units, that is a huge accomplishment, especially in this short period of time. And make sure you give that PlayStation Store sale a look. Some awesome deals, and it is ending very soon, tomorrow at 11 a.m. So take advantage of it while you can. Sound off with your thoughts in the comment section down below. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.